Hi, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Rudy and thank you so much for being here. You're probably here because you just watched Dr. Dre's video on the Aveeno Calm and Restore Oat line. My first thoughts after watching that video were one, I need it. Two, I want all of it, but I probably don't need all of it. And three, is that oat gel moisturizer going to replace my Neutrogena Hydro Boost? Dr. Dre even mentions in the video that if you didn't do well with the Neutrogena Hydro Boost, that this could be a good alternative for you. So of course I immediately bought it and I thought I need to make this video ASAP. I asked you guys over on my community tab if you'd be interested in this and I got a lot of responses. So I'm excited to get into this video. Please don't forget to subscribe before you leave. We talk about more than just skincare on this channel. We talk about makeup. We talk about tretinoin. We talk about lifestyle. We're doing vlogs.
We really do it all.
We're gonna cover some of the similarities and differences between these products. And we're also just gonna go over what would be best for you based on your skin type and the kind of skin problems that you deal with. The first thing that I want to cover is the similarities between these two and the things that I don't want to discuss over and over and over because they are exactly the same. And that is one, the price. The Neutrogena Hydro Boost, depending on where you shop from, is about $23 to $24. The Aveeno Gel Cream is the exact same amount. They are also both 1.7 ounces, so they have the exact amount of the same product. They also have pretty much the exact same packaging. Not exact, but almost identical. The Aveeno one is a little bit smaller, but it's the exact same component. It's just a little bit smaller. Bottom line, they're the same price, so it is the same value no matter what you get. And the other thing that these two have in common is that they are both essential oil free and fragrance free and also alcohol free. Not that alcohol would go in a moisturizer, but just saying, all of these are free from those irritating ingredients. So we're gonna have to really get into the nitty gritty to decide which one's gonna be better for you. So let's go over each of them and kind of talk about the differences and some of the standout ingredients. Let's start with the Hydro Boost. The Hydro Boost is essentially a very, very standard silicone style moisturizer. I would say it's one of the first gel style moisturizers that really caught on in the skincare community, probably because of Dr. Dre. She recommends this as a humectant to put on wet skin before you put on an occlusive layer of moisturizer on top of that. And that is also what I use this for. I have videos of myself using this in my morning and evening skincare routine that I can link below if you are curious, but how I use it in my routine is first thing out of the shower or while my face is wet, I put this on and then I apply my CeraVe PM or my SPF on top of that. So I want to draw attention to the fact that dimethicone is above glycerin on the ingredients list. So that just means that dimethicone, a silicone that's going to make the feel of the product very smooth, silky, and slippery, is actually higher on the list than the humectant, which is glycerin. A humectant is basically a property that is going to attract water to your skin, and then you put an occlusive layer on top to really keep that water in your skin. This does have those silicones in it, so technically you don't need to apply an occlusive layer. However, I don't know that this is going to be enough if you have combo or dry skin. Honestly, there's not much more to say about this product. It is incredibly standard. There are no real standout ingredients that I would call like a superstar ingredient because really this is just made to moisturize your face and nothing else. It's not meant to treat, it's not meant to help with sensitivity, it's not meant to help with acne, it's simply just a vehicle for moisture. However, if you are on a prescription strength acne medication like I am, something like this is actually great because you don't need a lot of other ingredients while you're working with something like tretinoin, which is what I'm on. If you're interested, I can leave an entire playlist about that acne medication up above. But when you're on something that's sensitizing like that, you actually want a moisturizer that's going to be very simple and just do the job of moisturizing your skin. This has been a tried and true for me, so I was hard pressed to find something better. Until the Aveeno one came out, I really was not interested in trying another kind. So let's talk about the Aveeno one. I have been using it for about 2 weeks, so I feel like I have a pretty good handle on how I feel about it. So the main difference here between the Aveeno and the Neutrogena is that the Aveeno was specifically made to help with sensitive skin. This is part of a line literally called Calm and Restore, okay? So this entire line was made with oat kernel flour. We'll get into some of those ingredients, but I did want to mention that the first humectant on the list is also glycerin, the exact same as the Hydro Boost. They have a lot of similar ingredients, in fact. Most of those silicone and humectant style products are in the Aveeno, plus some extra skin-loving ingredients on top of that. So there are four ingredients on top of the ingredients we just talked about in the Hydro Boost that I wanted to call attention to, and the first one is panthenol. I'm not gonna spend too much time on these because they are essentially all going to do the same thing for your skin, which is help with inflammation and sensitivity. So panthenol is great for that. The next ingredient I wanted to discuss is that oat kernel flour. If you watched my Leah Yu sensitive skin video, you'll notice that one of the remedies that I did was actually soaking cotton pads in oatmeal with water and placing them on my face to help with some of the inflammation and redness that I was dealing with. And that is exactly what oat kernel extract is going to do. It's really going to help calm the skin, and it is amazing for sensitive skin, especially for those of us who are using tretinoin and using a sensitizing ingredient within their skincare routine. Another standout ingredient that is in this list, this is one of the last ingredients, but it is in there, and that is centella extract. Centella is very popular in Korean skincare. I have an entire video on sensitive skin-friendly Korean skincare, so I was really excited to see that centella was included in this ingredients list. Centella is amazing for wound healing. It's great for all skin types. It's anti-inflammatory. Once again, it's really gonna help calm your skin. There's also one more important ingredient in this list that they really tout on the packaging, and that is feverfew flower extract. If you look up this ingredient, you're gonna find the same thing that I have been preaching this entire time. It's great for sensitive skin, anti-inflammatory, helps with redness. And if you go to the Aveeno website, you'll actually see that they have an entire section on how they get and extract their feverfew extract, and it's honestly very interesting. I can read you what it says from the website. It says, "We're choosy about where we grow our feverfew. It's USDA organic, pesticide-free fields, and they're isolated from urban pollution." There is a sensitizing ingredient in feverfew naturally, and they actually pull it out before they put the extraction in this product, which is really interesting. Okay, now that we know a little bit more about the ingredients, let's talk about which one would be better for you, and let's also talk about just like the general feel and how I felt about using both of them. So the Hydro Boost Extra Dry Skin is a nice, very lightweight gel cream. It has a white/clear consistency, and I feel like it really gives you a burst of moisture on your skin. It spreads very easily, and it feels incredibly lightweight. The Aveeno Calm and Restore is actually going to be a little bit more of a milky, oat color if you look at it. And that makes sense because there's a lot of oat in this. This feels, I would say, a good bit thicker on the skin than the Hydro Boost. If you like the Hydro Boost because it feels very light, airy, it sinks into the skin quickly, this is not quite as lightweight as the Hydro Boost. It still sinks in very quickly and it does feel nice on the face. However, it just feels slightly bit heavier than the Hydro Boost. It feels more like a moisturizer that has been put in a tub rather than a gel cream, in my opinion. However, I have really enjoyed using this. I have not had a single breakout since using this, and I do feel like some of the redness that I typically get on my cheeks, either the day after a tretinoin use or if I've been, you know, stressed and I'm having a flare up of acne, I feel like it has been reduced just a touch. I also wanted to mention that both of these come in a mini size, so if you were interested in trying out the Aveeno and you already had the Neutrogena Hydro Boost, you could get a miniature size of this from Ulta for about $10. Honestly, I could buy either one after I was done with these and have no problem with it. I think it just really depends on the type of feel that you like in your moisturizer, and also if you are averse to any of those ingredients in the Aveeno product. If you don't do well with centella, you're probably not gonna wanna purchase this. If you don't like the idea of putting oat on your face, well, obviously you're not gonna wanna purchase this. If you're looking for a more standard, no nonsense, nothing fancy ingredient-wise moisturizer, then definitely go with the Hydro Boost. If you're feeling really sensitized and you wanna kind of switch back and forth, I also think there are a few things that you can do, not just with this moisturizer, but with the entire Calm and Restore line. They also came out with a cleanser and a serum to go along with this moisturizer, and all of them have been Dr. Dre approved. I am interested in trying the cleanser actually, so I may pick that up. Let me know if you're interested in that. And also, I feel like the serum could be a great way for you to dip your toes into this line while still using your Hydro Boost. You could start by cleansing your skin, put a layer of the oat serum on, and then finish it with the Neutrogena Hydro Boost, whatever treatment you'd like after that, to kind of dip your toes into these ingredients. Because the serum is incredibly similar to the moisturizer by ingredients, they're almost identical. I think there's a little bit more oat extract in the serum, and it's just a watery consistency instead of a thicker gel. I also think the serum could be really great to apply on days in which you're feeling extremely sensitized without having to change up your entire routine. So if you don't like changing out multiple things at once and you just want to add something in that's going to be calming and restorative, as this line says, it could be good to just grab that serum and try and add it in on days where you're feeling really inflamed. Bottom line, these are both really nice. I enjoy using both of them. I honestly think the Aveeno might be better in the winter when you're having a little bit more irritation or dryness, and the Hydro Boost could be perfect in the summer, or you could use them interchangeably. Honestly, I love them both. I really love that there are some extra skin-loving ingredients in this formula, but if that's not what you're about, the Hydro Boost will do just as good of a job of moisturizing. I know we covered a lot today, but please let me know down below if you have any lingering questions. You know I'd be happy to talk to you guys in the comments, and I will see you guys in the next video really soon.